Hello, Ringgold High School. Thank you for watching Tiger Nation News. I'm Dominic Cawthorn.
And I am Sal Keith. Today is Friday, April 19th. And you know, David Carroll actually came to our class not too long ago. Wasn't that exciting?
Yeah, I mean, he was a pretty cool dude. He was real nice.
Yeah. Thank you to everyone that did come and visit us. And we truly do appreciate it. And thank you for taking time out of your day for us. Anyway, Dawson is in the studio with next week's lunch forecast. Dawson.
Hey guys, instead of a lunch forecast today, we wanted to take a moment to recognize our cafeteria team. They got a perfect score on their health inspection, and get this, they have had 100 for the last 21 inspections. That's 10 and a half years of perfection. In the past, the school board has recognized the RHS cafeteria team for their cleanliness. Congratulations, and thank you for keeping our cafeteria safe and clean.
Very cool. Thanks, Dawson. The PBIS Rewards Day will be on May 13th this year. RHS is looking for performers. We are looking for talented singers, bands, or guitarists. If you would like to audition to perform at the PBIS Rewards Day on May 13th, please see Coach Anna Crisp in room 103.
Seniors, we need your photos submitted to the senior slideshow. Today is the deadline, and only a few seniors have sent in their photos. We want to include everyone, but we need your help. Please submit up to 6 school-appropriate photos immediately. Email those to rhsslideshowpics@gmail.com.
Do you love to travel? Well, take a listen to this. Madam Phoebe is taking students on a trip to Paris and London in the summer of 2026. The informational meeting is next week, so we caught up with Madam Phoebe to ask her about the details.
The trip is June 2026. We haven't got definite dates yet. It'll be that first week of June, somewhere in there. We have to kind of wait on how many people are going so they can book the flights. They don't book the flights that early. We will be basically staying in London and Paris, but you will have some excursions. We will go to Windsor Castle as part of the London tour. Of course, you'll get to see all the sights in London. You also go to a London West End show. In Paris, you see the Louvre. You get to go to the Eiffel Tower. Go up on the second floor of the Eiffel Tower, and then as a extra excursion, you go to the Palace of Versailles, and I invite anyone and everyone. Parents can go.
Monday is Earth Day. Lynn Myers is in the studio to tell us about what we can do locally to do our part. Lynn?
Thank you. Earth Day is easily celebrated, and anyone can participate. We interviewed a student and a couple staff members about Earth Day. Check it out.
I love Earth Day.
I think it's very important, but I don't think we're near where we should be.
Tomorrow, there are multiple RHS students working with Lyft to participate in Clean Catoosa. This will be held from 9 to 12. The groups that are participating include the football team, RHSPA, and multiple National Beta Club members. Mrs. Wooten said they will be working by the farm to fork restaurant.
I think it's very important to obviously make the accomplishments of trying to, help the environment into not having as much plastic in the ocean or just using a lot of biodegradable materials.
The Clean Catoosa event picked up over 2,000 pounds of trash last year, and any help makes a huge difference in that number.
We like to plant herbs in our herb garden for Earth Day.
Honestly, I just try in my everyday life not to use fast fashion or mostly clothes with polyester because they do end up in landfills and don't degrade as good as cotton or wool.
We love the Earth Day. We gotta keep our Earth clean for future kids and children.
If you are a part of any groups who are participating in Clean Catoosa, there are still activities happening this weekend that you can do to celebrate Earth Day.
You can join Clean Catoosa by going to lift-ringgold.org/cleancatoosa and click on the individual sign-up link. Or maybe you want to help our neighbors at the Keep Dalton Whitfield Beautiful event. Volunteers will pick up trash on Mill Creek Road starting at Need to Feed Cafe at 9 a.m. There will be snacks and prizes.
Thank you, Dominic. Maybe you feel like venturing to the northern neighbors in Chattanooga. Saturday evening, Reflection Writing will host poetry among the trees. Immerse yourself in nature while enjoying poetry readings from local poets. The music of Rick Rushing, micro nature walks, and snacks and a bonfire will all take place there. Tickets are only $10, and it's at Reflection Writing at 5:30 p.m.
This weekend, the band marches in the Cherry Blossom Parade in Washington, D.C. CNN reporter Abby Riddle is in the studio with that story.
Abby? That's right. The band went to D.C. for the parade, but it was an opportunity to do much more. Band members Brody Haddock, Betts Fallon, Addie Talley, and Grant Mullins laid a wreath on the tomb of the unknown soldier. It's a great honor. We sat down with Brody Haddock to tell us about the experience.
I have been drum major of the Ringgold Marching Tiger Band for 3 years and have been the head drum major for 2 years. So this was actually the main event, the Cherry Blossom Parade was, and this was something that we actually applied for. We put in application of our past marching shows to have the eligibility to go and march in this parade. So it was a very selective process. I think there was only 18 bands in this parade. So they were very selective, and this was a national parade. Anyone could apply. So this is a very big deal for our school. And also, this was also an honor to, again, see this on TV and then us marching down Constitution Avenue, where we've seen all these years watching this parade. We all got the honor of laying the wreath at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier in Washington, D.C. at Arlington National Cemetery. This was an honor because this tomb represented the soldiers that were not found on the battlefield. So we were laying this wreath to represent Ringgold Marching Tiger Band as well as Ringgold High School to pay our respects as well as an honor of laying this to represent our respects. So Mr. Wright and Miss Nails, our band director and assistant band director, they were asked to do it on behalf of the band, but Mr. Wright wanted the band officers to represent the band because he wanted us to have that experience. So this was something I'm thankful that he gave me the opportunity to do, as well as my colleagues and co-students. And it's something that I'll remember forever, and it just made me realize how thankful I am to have a band director like Tracy Wright, as well as a school that has given me the opportunity to honor the lives that were lost. This made me realize the amount of lives lost and what they have done to pay respects for the lives lost. So it just made me realize how little I am compared to the men and women that fought for our freedom. Thank you, Mr. Wright, for the time and dedication you put into making our band a success, as well as making sure that we represent ourselves well. You've given me this opportunity to be the drum major, as well as the opportunity to lay the wreath and on behalf of the band and the school. So I just want to thank you so much for everything that you've given me. And I'll really miss you. I'll miss coming back and seeing you at the games. So I hope you have a happy retirement.
Congratulations to our Student Athletes of the Month, Nolan Birchfield and Ivy O'Neill. Nolan is a senior member of the varsity football team. He was named second team in all region for the 2023 season. Nolan was also selected to play in the Blue-Gray All-American Florida game this year. Nolan says the RHS teacher who has impacted him the most is Miss Mullick. After high school, Nolan plans to attend Berea College and major in biology, taking the pre-med track.
Ivy O'Neill is a junior here at RHS. After high school, Ivy would love to continue her love of music in college or do shows with Broadway touring companies as a job. When asked who has impacted her at RHS, Ivy says Miss Ellis and Miss Schroeder. She says she is a very important member of RHSPA, of course. You would know this if you saw her as the lead in Peter Pan this year. In fact, you might remember she was nominated for Best Actress at Shuler's, the event that happened last night.
Did you see it? Well, let me tell you, this event knocked our socks off. The RHSPA performed live in the Shuler Awards that aired live on Georgia Public Broadcasting last night. They came home with 5 winning categories: Best Technical Execution, Best Musical Direction, Best Leading Actress, and Best Choreography and Standing Ovation Award. Here are some of the highlights from the show.
And the Shuler goes to
Kelly Schroeder,
Nahima Diggs,
and Macy McCorkle.
I just want to give a big thanks to the cast and crew of Peter Pan, and I love you all so much, and I would also like to thank my mom and my dad and my grandma and all my family. And I would also like to thank Kelly Schroeder, and I just want you guys to know to never give up and always believe in yourself, because you can do it.
So this was our first time flying anyone in our theater, and it's a pretty big undertaking, so I want to take a minute to thank the RHSPA Flight Club, which is our group of 7 volunteers who sacrificed hours and hours of their time to man our fly lines. They're in the audience, you're hearing them right now, to man our fly lines backstage. It was such a big undertaking. I want to thank ZFX Flying and our flight instructor, Johnny Pickett. And I want to thank our administration and our school board for approving such a thing to happen at our theater. Thank you so much.
And the Shuler Award for Best Music Direction goes to Braden Roach and Jaden Hatch, Ringgold High School.
First, I would love to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I would love to thank the cast and crew of Peter Pan for making this possible. I want to thank our amazing directors. I want to thank my family for all their support.
Whoa, okay. We would like to thank our parents, our directors, everyone who has helped us with our show. Our leads are so amazing, and they have helped our show so much to grow. And we would just love to thank ArtsBridge for this opportunity. Thank you so much.
And the Shuler goes to Sophia Thomas, Cherish Hedrick, and Luke Garverick, Ringgold High School, Peter Pan!
Oh my gosh, wow. I just want to say thank you so much to my family and friends and the amazing cast and crew of Peter Pan. This wouldn't have been possible without them. And I just want to say thank you to God for all of these opportunities. This is so amazing. Thank you.
All of this wouldn't have been possible without our amazing directors, Janae Ellis and Kelly Schroeder. They have worked so hard behind the scenes for our show, and they've always made sure our show has gone perfectly. They give us so many opportunities to show our talents on stage.
And also we want to say thank you to Luke Garvick, our assistant dance captain and best friend. We love him. Thank you, Art Brew.
The winners of the awards for best leading performers are... Hayden Poe and Ivy O'Neill. Dalton High School and Ringgold High School.
What a night for our performing arts program. Ivy O'Neill, the best leading actress, will represent RHS as she competes at the Jimmy Awards in New York this summer.
We want to give a big shout out to the Ringgold Middle School Performing Arts. They performed their musical, The Sound of Music, last week in our auditorium. We were able to stop by and take a little peek. Here's some video footage from one of their performances. We are very proud of them, and we hope that they choose to become future members of the RHS Performing Arts when they enter our high school.
We're going to take a little break. When we come back, we'll be introduced to this year's valedictorian.
To this year's valedictorian, Riley Burdett. We caught up with Riley and asked her a few questions about what that achievement means to her.
To me, it's a huge accomplishment knowing, like, being the top of the class. It's been a goal of mine since freshman year. There was a time I didn't really think about it, and then this year it kind of got real. I want to be remembered for not really one thing specific, but I tend to be the kind of person who I fit in everywhere but also nowhere. For being a good athlete, being a good student, being a good artist, just leaving a little bit of everything behind. I've had a lot of good memories in high school, whether it be sports or in class. It's gonna be hard, but just think, you know, in a few weeks we'll be out of here, especially for seniors. This is the last time that we will ever be here, so just try to enjoy it because you don't want to look back and regret not taking advantage of those last few weeks.
Next week, we will introduce you to this year's salutatorian. Okay, speaking of seniors, listen up. There are lots of events happening over the next few weeks.
The Ringgold Primary Senior Walk will be Thursday, April 25th at 1:45 p.m. Keep in mind the road closure at Poplar Springs Road. Make sure to remember your cap and gown.
The senior trip to Top Golf is still for Monday, April 29th, from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. on May 3rd. The senior walk will be at Graysville Elementary and will be at noon. Wear your cap and gown.
More senior walk announcements have just came in. The senior walk for Westside students who are graduating will be on May 13th. This is for Heritage, Lakeview, and RHS students. You should meet in the Westside lobby at 8:15 in cap and gown. Light refreshments will be provided.
The senior walk for seniors who attended Tiger Creek Elementary will be on May 14th at noon. You are also invited to lunch there as well. Also, make sure to bring your cap and gown.
The senior walk for Battlefield Elementary will be on Wednesday, May 15th at 8 a.m. The Cloud Spring senior walk will be on the same day. Do not forget your cap and gown. We're going to take a break. When we come back, TNN reporter Bryce Hart will have this week's sports.
My name is Ms. Fueling, and in 10 years, I will be retired and sitting on my bum.
Hi, I'm Will Burgess, and in 10 years, I'll have won 3 Oscars.
Hi, I'm Ms. Manning, and in 10 years, my own 3 boys at home will be grown and almost all out of the house, which is strange. Hopefully, I will still be teaching here. And maybe my students that I have now will have kids that they're talking to about how much fun they had in my AB classes.
In 10 years, I'm going to play in the Masters.
In 10 years, I'm going to be beating Scotty Searcy in the Masters.
In 10 years, I will be in a hospital being a pediatrician.
In 10 years, I'm going to be an FNCS god at Fortnite.
Hey, in 10 years, I'm either going to be a real estate agent or a lawyer because I need to make bank because I need to be bougie.
In 10 years, I'm going to be in school to be a physical therapist.
In 10 years, I'll hopefully be in college or have a marine biology degree.
In 10 years, I'll be 26, and so I picture myself being pretty much done with college and getting ready to start a job somewhere in a hospital and be some sort of nurse.
I'm Joseph Brumfield.
And I'm Miss Crisp.
What chapter do you teach?
I teach English, and I'm in the Tiger Success Academy for part of my day.
How long have you worked at RHS?
This is my 5th year at Ringgold.
Where did you go to high school?
I went to Gordon Lee High School.
What is your favorite food?
My favorite food is anything Mexican. I love Mexican food.
What do you like to do for fun?
For fun, I like to hang out with my husband and our daughter and just be lazy around the house and not do much of anything because we're usually busy here at school. So that's my fun, is being lazy.
Are you the RHS team leader coach?
I am.
Are you excited for Friday Night Lights?
I am very excited. I love Friday Night Lights.
Will you do a cheer for us?
Okay, I'll do a cheer, but you have to do it with me. You have to say it back, okay? Ready? Okay. When I say Ringgold, you say Tigers. Ringgold.
Tigers.
Ringgold.
Tigers.
Okay, yeah, and do spirit fingers. All right.
As you can see, I'm not Bryce Hart, but the Shulers has him feeling a little tired today, so I'm going to step in for him. But for sports and baseball, last Friday was senior night. The first pitch was thrown out by Mr. Nix and Mr. Lusk, and along with a few other faculty members in honor of the new baseball facilities. They won 11-1 against Lafayette at home. The Tigers are to host the first round of playoffs this coming Tuesday at home because they beat Gordon Lee last Tuesday to win the region. In track, region is next week. We spoke to Coach White and Coach Warren to see how they feel this year. Here's what they had to say.
Hi, I'm Sav Stevens. I'm in 12th grade and I'm 18. Some of my hobbies are art and sewing. I listen to lots of kinds of music, but I think Hozier is probably my favorite artist. And one of, I guess, a quote is, be who you are, don't try to be someone else.
Hey guys, I'm Abby. I'm 17 and I'm a senior. I like music and guitar and anything like that. I think that my quote would be, if you want beef jerky, just go get it.
We leave you now with the number of the RHSPA performed at the Schuller Awards last night. Thank you for watching and go,
go Tigers.
From Peter Pan, here's Ringgold High School with I Won't Grow Up.
Someone tries to make them.
They will simply run away.
They will simply run away.
I won't.